when they were about to leave. Then Pharaoh restricted their leave to worship God for many weeks or months or years. And then God started to deal with this problem. Started with plagues. And every time, Pharaoh is coming and to say, sorry, I am going to leave you to go. But one of them was quite strange. In Exodus chapter 8, and verse 9 and 10. And Moses said to Pharaoh, now it was the plague of frogs. Accept the honor of saying when I shall intercede for you. I'm going to end your affliction. I'm going to stop this plague. And now it's your own choice. Can you choose a time for your own freedom? For your servants and for your people to destroy the frogs from you and your houses that they may remain in the river only. And here is a strange answer of it looks strange, but it might be your answer and my answer this morning. So he said, tomorrow. So he's seeking one more night under the plague, one more night with the frogs. He is not willing to be freed on this day. As a question today for you and for me, is this prodigal son was able to say, today, now, I will arise and go to my father. Unfortunately, most of us saying, tomorrow, I will repent. I need one more night with the frogs. One more night under the plague. One more night doing something against God's will. Believing that I am in the right place. Why I need it for one more night. But he's telling us, no more nights. The prodigal son today, yes, he is telling you and me, you have the opportunity to say today, not tomorrow. In Jeremiah, was encouraging us, all of us, yes, for years maybe I was saying tomorrow, and tomorrow didn't come yet. But Jeremiah was praying for us and with us all. I have surely heard Ephraim bemoaning himself. You have chastised me. And I was chastised like an untrained bull. Restore me, and I will return. The prodigal son on this day, he accepted the restoration. He didn't delay it for tomorrow. He didn't ask for one more night under these frogs. So the frogs, it might be something too small or too big, but still I'm under the plague. Still I'm not in full obedience to accept God's calling. I'm ready to free you today, not only tomorrow. Unfortunately, it was for him tomorrow. But because it was an attitude in his life, I will say, yes, I'm going to repent. Sometimes he said, yes, I'm going to repent today. But he did nothing. That's why it were nine plagues. And then it became the tenth one in which he lost everything, even his life. That's why the prodigal son is encouraging us to say, today I will rise. Today I will say something different from what I used to say in my life in the past. St. Paul is telling us, there's a big question mark here. He's asking you, are you belonging to Christ? If yes, there is only one direction. And those who are Christ have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. Is encouraging us. Yes, your frog, it might be one of your passions. It's your career. It's your family. It is your money. It is lust or desire. It's envy. It's fear. Whatever it is. It's thinking now you need to reaffirm your first calling in day one when you are baptized. I belong to Christ. I profess him as a king and savior for me. Here is the opposite of the verse. And there is nothing in between. And those who are not Christ have not crucified the flesh, and they are not following, and they are following their own desires and passions. He's putting both of them in front of me. Either to say tomorrow I want to enjoy one more night with the frogs, or it's time to stop it, because I lost a lot, maybe of years, I mean most of my life, saying tomorrow I am going to repent. Tomorrow I'm going to start something else. Back to our reading today. And the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that falls to me. So he divided to them his livelihood, and not many days after, the younger son gathered all together, journeyed to a far country. Again, it's about me. When I think of myself, I can think properly. When I think of my Savior, my calling, St. Paul says in Hebrews chapter 3, verse 1, we are all partakers of a heavenly calling. Are you pursuing your heavenly calling this morning, or you are saying, one more night with the frogs, leave it for tomorrow? Sometimes, we heard it many times in confessions. Some people say, I'm afraid to repent. To this point that the devil can deceive me. If I will repent, I will lose. I lose the pleasure of sin. I will lose sometimes friendship, unholy friendships. But he is telling me today, it's time to choose the bosom of your Heavenly Father, who is waiting for each and every one of us, whatsoever you have done in your past. St. John Climacus, as we are reading together the 30 steps to heaven, is telling us, he who follows his own ideas in opposition to the direction of his superiors needs no devil to tempt him, for he is a devil to himself. Again, are you confessing regularly? Are you going to your spiritual father regularly to take the directions of the church, the directions of the Word of God, to redirect myself and to say no more nights with the frogs anymore? The same problem was for the older son. He is a churchgoer. He's in the father's house day and night. And remember one important thing. At the beginning of the parable, the Lord was telling them, the father divided everything between both of them. So in actual fact, everything now in the house, everything belongs to the father, is owned by this other son. But he lived as a servant. You did not give me anything. In actual fact, you are the son of God who owns everything. But still your tongue saying, I have nothing. You didn't give me anything yet. Again, what he was using, I. These many years, I have been serving you. I never transgressed your commandments at any time. And yet never gave me a young goat that I might make merry with my friends. Again, are you crucifying yourself with your passions and desires, or still me and I? The younger son said me, and the older son was saying I. And this is the key issue. If you are still saying I and me, you are calling for one more night with the frogs, one more night under the plague, not enjoying the freedom that you are called to be. You go to the whole story of the Exodus of the Israelites. God wants to bless both of them, the Israelites to be freed and the Egyptians. And many times, if you read in the book of Exodus, he was saying that may the Egyptians know that I am God. But it ends up, they know it in a very negative way. It is God who destroyed our Pharaoh, who destroyed our army. Why? Because of our disobedience through our king, the Pharaoh. That's why the Lord was telling us, yes, I know you can say easily, I have a very weak will. I can't make it. I tried many times to say tonight, not tomorrow, today. But I have a very weak will. And here again what St. Cyril is teaching us. Christ took our full humanity. He was incarnate and became man. Why? To tell us, I have taken a will like yours. And I was able to make it surrender totally to the Father. And now I'm offering you this gift. I have done everything in myself for your sake, to be able to say my words. He said it just a few hours before the cross. Father, if it is your will, take this cup away from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but yours be done. It is not great words of the Lord to hear it. It's a great gift. He has done it in himself to offer it to you and to me this morning. And all the day long, that we are able to enjoy the fullness of this surrender to the will of the Father. St. John Chrysostom is commenting, on each occasion I say, Lord, your will be done. It is not what this or that one wants, but what you want me to do. This is my fortress, this is my firm rock, this is my sure support. I am in your will. I am not following my own desire. Yes, you have a desire, and maybe it's a holy desire. Put it on the altar and tell him, choose it for me. If you remember the story of Isaac and Abraham, God told him, offer your son. Why? One of the church fathers was commenting on this. He said, because at this moment, Isaac had a place and occupied a big part of the heart of Abraham. God wants all your heart. Once Abraham was able to take it off, put it in the altar, God told him, I don't need him. I was in need of your whole heart. Now take him back, whole and sound. And more than that, there is a ram to be sacrificed for him. So he's asking you and me this morning, bring your frogs, bring your desires, bring whatever you feel it's even holy on the altar. I will sanctify it and will give it you back once more. Saint John is telling us in his epistle that why you are not able to make it, why I'm saying tomorrow, why I'm saying give me a chance, I will end this relationship, I will end this bad habit, I will end this addiction at one point, but not now. I'm not ready for it now. Why? Hear what St. John is advising us. But whoever keeps his word, the word of God, truly the love of God is perfected in him. The word is not abiding yet in me. St. James is telling us we need the word to be implanted, not only to be heard. Yes, it's good to hear it. It's good to share it. But we need to be implanted in our heart to be able to move us towards eternity. By this we know that we are in him. He who says he abides in him ought himself also to walk just as he walked. So he's telling us, here is the consequence. Know the word, commit yourself in it, and it will perfect you. Then you will be able to walk as he did. You'll be able, not my will, but your will, as the Son said it. Saint Ignatius of Antioch was telling us, it is not hard to obey when we love the one whom we obey. He's telling me and you, the problem is about love. The prodigal son knows that he is going to be accepted in a sense. That's why he said, I will go now. Even if my father will make me like one of his hired workers, I'm going to accept it. But thank God, the Bible was telling us, yes, in him, between him and himself, he said, if he will accept me as a hired worker, it's fine. The father didn't allow him to say this word. He welcomed him. He hugged him. He was waiting for him from a far distance. But please don't tell him one more night with the frogs anymore. St. Paul is teaching us in his second and chapter 10 and verse 5. Yes, you have something in your mind now telling you, yes, it looks nice, but it's not for today again. It looks nice, but it's not for me. I can do everything, but this frog, one of these frogs, should stay with me at least for a while. And this is not from God. This is another way of deception. Leave one for a while. Cut your unholy relationships, but keep the phone numbers. You might need them later. Cut this, but keep a small door. You might need this sin later, and it will destroy you. In 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 5, saying, if you have such arguments in your mind, if the devil is trying to put such things in your mind, be aware. Casting down arguments and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. If it's against the knowledge of God, cast it down. The Lord, with the power of the Holy Spirit, is able to destroy such arguments. Bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ. Are not here to be in the obedience of myself, in the obedience of whosoever, to the obedience of Christ. The church is encouraging us not only to read such wonderful gospels that the Father is waiting for you, he's waiting for you in person and today. Why? Because we decided not to be like Pharaoh, no more nights with the frogs. St. Gregory the Great was commenting on this obedience, was saying, by the other virtues, we offer God what we possess. but by obedience we offer ourselves. He's saying, now I'm looking for a great sacrifice. Nearly the same words said by Saint Hilary of Poitiers. He was telling us the greatest gift we have been given from God is our free will. And the greatest sacrifice is to give him back our free wills once more. Tell him, I don't need to have my own desire to be fulfilled. It will be not my will, but your will at all times. They who obey are conquerors. Sometimes it feels the opposite. When I force my wife or my kids or my husband to do whatever I want, I'm a victorious. It's totally the opposite. When you are in full obedience, you are a conqueror. Because by submitting themselves to obedience, they triumph over the angels who fell through the sea. What is your choice? Use the victorious angels or the fallen angels? And the key word was obedience and disobedience. Finally, let me leave these two thoughts with you before we go. Discover your own frogs. One is more than enough to destroy it, to destroy my life. Sometimes there are many. And again, it is not about tomorrow, it's about today. Find out a time to sit with your spiritual father, to tell him where you stand exactly. Sometimes you feel, I can kick my frogs with my own. No, you need Moses. Pharaoh cannot do it. He was the great king of his time. He cannot do it. You need Moses. You need Aaron to come with him as well. We need the church with us. We need to consult our spiritual fathers to know where we go and how we go. May the good Lord Jesus Christ be with you from now and forever and ever. Amen.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, for thine is the glory forever.